Today on Typical Books, we're going to talk about some of the books that I've read since finishing the Read What You Own challenge. It was only a 25 book challenge, so it's not like it was a great big thing, but yeah, some books that weren't for me. Now, I do want to say right off, this was a patron pick, and I am the one that picks what's on the patron pick poll, so it's not about what was picked, it's about what I put on it. And I had, in the past 2 years or so, been reading more YA books, and I think this might be the end of that because it's really not for me. I do desire something more horrific from my horror, and I am going to be 50 in a couple years, very short years, so I don't think the YA really works for me. Now, there was a time, and I think it was going through the virus, where people needed some more cozy reading, and that's probably where my desire to check out YA titles had come from. So yeah, we're done with that. So I'm going to be done with reading the more cozier books. That does not include things like haunted house novels. I may still dip into YA for the haunted house stuff because it really lives side by side with cozy horror, cozy adult horror. You may note Darcy Coates writes a lot of really cool cozy horror. I'm certainly going to be continuing to read certain types of books from her, but we're going to talk about the My Throat in Open Grave by Tori Bovolino, which was really fun, but I was really of two minds with it. Before we get into that, something I loved, you might have seen me posting on Instagram, In a Lonely Place, Carl Edward Wagner. Styx is one of my favorite short stories ever, and it has been for years and years and years. If you are interested in hearing a radio play version of it, I can probably find the link and put it in the notes below. It's really, really, really wonderful to listen to, and it is just wonderful to read and always will be. So yeah, I really enjoyed that. Valancourt Books puts out amazing reissues, so definitely check this out, especially if Carl Edward Wagner is a new name to you. Then I picked up some books right after that just weren't for me. And I tried like some little bits of reading, little short books, and one looked gorgeous, 19 Little Stab Wounds. This I stole from my husband's bookshelf by Alexis Dubon, and we picked this up at StokerCon in the dealer's room. And the artwork is amazing, and it is very poetic, so I will have some poetry coming up very soon on the channel, and I like stuff like Rath James White writes amazing poetry, and I do like some of the poetry that's in like Nightworms, the zine. And these are short stories. These are little drabbles, little micro fictions, which is neat too. And I thought that would appeal to me because there's 19 little stab wounds, little picarist short stories, if you will. And there's some very cute little ghost stories that I really did like, but it was just a little too poetic. And I guess when I'm in a poetry frame of mind, I want my poems to be poems and I want my prose to be prose or something, I don't know. But I do like very poetic prose, like Kathy Koja writes very poetic prose in my estimation. So I don't know why this was a miss for me, but I can see it being a hit for a lot of people. So I still recommend it because if you like something a little more whimsical, then 19 Little Stab Wounds may be for you. Not a sentence you'd think you'd say all the time. 19 Little Stab Wounds may be for you. Waif by Samantha Kolasnik. I did enjoy this quite a lot, but it still missed some marks for me. I think what I wanted was something longer, a little more meaty, and I wanted a longer time spent with the couple because there is a couple in this and the female is a wretched human being and she really wants something else from her husband, and that instigates some body dysmorphia on his part perhaps, or just wanting to throw his money around and please his wife for whatever reason. I don't know why he'd want to please her because she's pretty horrible. But yeah, a really good study in horrible people if you like that. And I do. And I do like her writing and I like the way this is written. All these books have written really well. And we'll get to the one that's written the best, but that I like the least. Oh well. Waif was good. Just, I don't know what it was. Maybe it was just the way that the story changed halfway through to be about some very different people. I wish I could read that story. We got sort of a Cronenberg style story going on here where we deal with body issues and it gets kind of body horror, but it doesn't go all in there. We have some angry, horrible people that are trapped in a relationship together, and we don't stay there. And then we have a sort of subculture, counterculture sort of organization, not unlike Fight Club, but a girl Fight Club in a way, but worse than that. And we don't go all in there. So I think I wanted to follow one of those threads longer than I was able to. But yeah, really good. I'm so glad that it's been reissued. Oh my gosh. I do have to say a big thank you to Off Limits Press for reissuing that, because I probably wouldn't have gotten it otherwise. This book was the patron pick. Speaking of the patron pick, there is a new one. It's a tie. As far as I can see, yeah, it's still a tie. Oh no, it's not. The Haunting of Belkwood by Gwendolyn Keist is what I'm going to be reading. I came here to do this video to announce a tie-breaking poll that I'll post up on YouTube, and just shortly before, I guess, or during recording, another vote rolled in. So hey, here we are announcing the next patron pick poll read for next month will be The Haunting of Belkwood by Gwendolyn Keist. You're welcome to read along. If you want to hear more about that particular book, Jason from Jason's Weird Reads interviewed Gwendolyn Keist not long ago. It was a live stream. I'm pretty sure it's up now, The Haunting of Gwendolyn Keist, and it was really cool. I got to hang out for most of that. I only missed a little at the beginning, then went back and watched it again. So if you're interested in watching the author interview, definitely check that out. If you've already read The Haunting of Gwendolyn Keist, don't spoil it for me, because I'm very interested in reading about these commingled stories taking place in a town that is under a veil of foggy secrecy, and it is sort of like a supernatural place, not unlike My Throat and Open Grave. The plot here is likened to Labyrinth, in that a young girl leaves her town to rescue her brother, who's been kidnapped by the Lord of the Wood, in this case, or LOW, as they so jauntily call him. I thought that this was a period piece. It's not. It is contemporary, and I loved it. I loved that. I loved that it is a folk horror told in the common era. People have cell phones and people watch trash TV. I like it. I like that a lot. There's a lot I like about this book. The style is very good. It's very well written. I like the characters, even the little tiny characters. Fletcher is like this person who hangs out that is a like a helper of some sort, like a house person or something. And they are really cool. They're the one that watches trash TV, but they're also trapped into this Lord of the Wood place, the Hollow, where they live. And it is a place across the river, somewhere in like Pennsylvania. It's within the Appalachian Mountains, so that's a different state, I think. I'm thinking of the Poconos, perhaps. But Appalachia goes through New York State as well. So this could be anywhere on the East Coast. Very interesting how people come of their own accord to this little hovel, this hollow that is hidden in the woods under a veil of secrecy. Also, people get kidnapped there as well, because if somebody offers someone else from the small towns nearby, the Lord of the Wood has rights to go and claim them, much like little Owen, a baby. I think he's 3 months old, and he is Lee's younger brother, and he gets taken by the Lord of the Wood, who, of course, and this is where the story gets weird to me. So the first like third is awesome. The last like eighth is great. And like sort of the big reveal, the big triple reveal, the third reveal of all the reveals is really good. This middle part is YA fantasy romance, and that's not for me. I didn't know that's what it was. I didn't know it was a romance, and it really is more of a romance than a horror. Oh well, it has a fantastic cover. It is a beautifully bound, beautifully printed book. I love that. And some people might not like this, that it is a wrap hardcover of the same cover that is on the dust jacket. It's not a traditionally printed hardcover book in that sense, but it is gorgeous. And I love this. I love the selection of the font. I like the saturation of the ink. It is slightly desaturated, it seems to me, so all the ink seems a little bit gray. I like the frontispiece on each chapter. I think it's just a gorgeously put together book. And the even the back pieces, where you have a little bit of advertising for the author's other books. It's just tastefully done. It's a very tastefully done book, and I can see how this would work very well in an ebook. So you're going to probably get, and I'm just guessing here, but it would be foolish if it wasn't this way, the same experience reading this on an ebook that you do reading it hardcover or paperback, because it looks like they're going to use the exact same files for everything, so it's not vastly different. And I think that's lovely. I think it's a lovely thing. It's a lovely book. It's just the middle part's not for me. A lot of the pandering made for an awkward reading experience from time to time, although I really love the character that was attached to. And of course, the weird way that it is feminist, not feminist, where, you know, a Bechdel test or Bechdel test, however you pronounce it, isn't something I like to apply to books or films, because a lot of times it fails and it's still a wonderful thing, or a lot of times it is a feminist thing and they just happen to fulfill a lot of the rules of that test. But it is handy from time to time when you're trying to place what it is about this book that strikes you as so anti-feminist. It's the fact that it's all about the dude. Now, I am not one to go social science on something like fiction, and I did enjoy a lot of this book, but I really rolled my eyes, and I don't know if it's because I'm a little older and I'm not interested in romance to begin with. I'm not interested in her wanting to be seduced, or the want of the Lord of the Woods to just seduce her, and none of that interested me whatsoever. I wanted him to be an aloof king of the forest, and not a sexy love interest. And maybe it is my age, because it's just gross reading about young people wanting to get it on. It's gross. Although the spicy scene, as people say, the sex scene, was really fantastical, and it was no different really than the sex scene in Fight Club. And I've said Fight Club twice in this, so I'm gonna have to watch it sometime soon, where it's just, you know, really surrealistic, impressionistic. It's not like pounding flesh or anything like that. So it is like really light. If you don't like sex scenes, like I don't, I think it did very, very well. It just still wasn't for me. The wraparound story, though, of The Lord of the Woods is great. It is a great folk horror. So if you like YA, if you like romance fantasy, this is really fun. If you're in for the horror like I was, maybe not so much. So we've had like a whole deal of disappointments here. I picked up a Jack London book for a cleanse palette, People of the Abyss, where he goes to London, right? A few years, maybe a decade after the Whitechapel murders, Jack the Ripper, and hangs out with all the destitute and forlorn. So I think that will really brighten my day. We have all these review copies, Grey Dog, Withered. This is gonna be fantastic. And before I get to those, I'm Hallow by Tim McGregor. My podcast partner, Wes Dead Air Knight from the Dead Air podcast, actually specifically recommended that I get to that soon because he's very curious. So I'll be reading it so he doesn't have to. Although he probably will, I bet you, by the time I'm done. Anyway, have you read any of those? Did you read My Throat an Open Grave? Are you interested in following along while I read The Haunting of Velkwood by Gwendolyn Keist? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you ever so much for watching, and have an ooky spooky day.